And today we take a look at the spirit of tequila. First, Casa Mexico Tequila takes us from the agave plant to the bottle.
The secret of making a great tequila is being passionate, taking your time. We don't cut any corners because we believe in quality over quantity.
Then, sampling the finished product.
What I typically look for in tequila is smooth and subtle. You don't need to shoot the tequila. No chaser needed.
Also, creating tequila cocktails for the official Casa Mexico US launch with fellow partner Mario Lopez.
Good. These are dangerous.
These dangerously smooth.
These creep up on you.
Wow, that is good, right? Great Cheers, job. Man. Great Cheers, trip.
Salud.
That's all next on The Art of Tequila.
The secret of making a great tequila is taking your time, being patient, being passionate. We take the long road. We don't cut any corners. We go the extra mile. We can produce sooner, but we don't because we believe in quality over quantity. And I think that's what it really stands for when it comes to making an excellent premium tequila. My name is Eric Buccio, and the founder, president, CEO of Casa Mexico.
Casa Mexico is a premium small batch tequila company started by Eric Buccio in 2001 to pay homage to his love of tequila.
What first interested me in tequila was that I grew up in such a Mexican household. Everything was tequila. And as a kid, I said, look, this is something that makes people happy. Maybe one day I'm gonna get in that business and I'm gonna make people happy with my product and make sure that they have a good time because that's what it was even in bad times.
The experience I want customers to have with Casa Mexico is basically an authentic, high-end, premium tequila. And I want them to understand that we don't only do tequila just to do tequila. We want people to have a good time.
Casa Mexico was in its infancy when it caught the eye of Mario Lopez. He was so blown away that he decided to become part of the company.
A friend of mine knew I was a tequila drinker and a fan and said, hey, a buddy of mine, a guy I know, has this great new tequila. I think you really like it. And what I really liked about Casa Mexico tequila is that it was very smooth. It had a good taste. And it was strong without feeling like it was strong going down. It sort of really kind of, I think, captures the whole like essence of the Mexican laid-back vibe. My role is to help raise the awareness level, to incorporate it into different events, whether it's my relationship with Oscar De La Hoya and Golden Boy Boxing and that audience, to promote it. I don't really put my name or back something that I don't believe in or I can't speak passionately about. If it doesn't feel authentic, it makes it easy when it comes to the Casa Mexico tequila because it's organic for who I am.
When choosing a name, Buccio wanted something that would evoke memories of his childhood and family traditions.
The significance of Casa Mexico is basically growing up in such a Mexican family.
Being born in Mexico but raised in the United States, I'd always hear my parents be very proud of being from Mexico. And they would always want to teach people what Mexico was about. So when people would come over the house, they would say, pásale a su casa, come to my house. My casa es tu casa. You know, I was stuck in my ear. It was like, anybody who comes here is gonna experience a Mexican house. So from that point on, what I did is very simple. The equation was, this is Casa Mexico.
That's where the name came from.
More than any other spirit, tequila is strongly rooted into the Mexican experience, a tradition that Casa Mexico pays homage to.
My name is Tacho Leyva, and my main role in this, in Casa Mexico, is run the distillery. The tequila is a big part of the culture of this area. It's part of the lifestyle of the day-to-day of every single person that lives in this area.
Jalisco makes tequila. It's really the only state that can make it. And to me, it's a special place because it's where my product actually is born and made. I want people to drink the product, enjoy it, sip it, and chat about their experiences and chat about what they've gone through, but in a very respectful, responsible way. That's what Casa Mexico is about.
Tequila is made from the Blue Weber agave plant and originated in the Mexican state of Jalisco, where Casa Mexico's distillery calls home.
The highlands of Jalisco is a special place where the best tequilas in the world are made. This region is so important for the tequila industry, first of all, because it started in Jalisco. It slowly has matured into other states, but bottom line comes down to Jalisco is known for tequila around the world. You don't think of these other states that actually can produce tequila as real true tequila states. There's a lot of factors that make this place a great place to produce tequila. One of the main factors is the soil. It's got volcanic red soil. It has a lot of minerals. That gives you a different taste to a tequila. Here, the highlands being up so high, you know, you're like 6,000 feet, have made the plant be more resistant to weather. The rain and the climate helps feed the plant for 8 years for it to reach its maturity at a faster pace instead of you waiting 12 years, which is usually 8 to 12. So we get an 8-year, well-matured plant with an amazing taste.
There's around 2,000 brands of tequila in Mexico. It's a lot of competition that we have. I think that Casa Mexico is special from the rest of the tequilas because we're very focused in all the details in every process from cutting the agave to get the bottle to the client. It's always be focused on the detail.
It's that attention to detail that goes into every aspect of Casa Mexico's production process.
Distilling tequila is definitely an art. People only see bottles. They don't see the real true craft of making a tequila.
The process involved in tequila is quite simple, but at the same time, very tedious. The hijuelo, which is the seed of the agave, has to be planted. It takes 8 years for the agave to mature. From that point on, what happens is the harvesting. Typically what they use is what we call una espátula. It's like a large spatula that they use to cut stuff, but it's angled at a certain way where they could round the piña. That tool is specially made and was brought to by many, many years ago by the Nahuatl Indians. No machine could actually do what he did with that tool. So that particular spatula is the only thing that can actually cut those pencas, which is very amazing. So what happens is they dig out the piña, they cut all the pencas, which are the leaves, and once that is removed, the piña is what really matters. That's where we get the juices for the tequila.
You will get a really nice product with this.
I think we are gonna have great product. The most mature part of the piña is within the piña. So everything around it, it's green, has to go. So look at this. The texture is great. I mean, they're ready, they're perfect mature, dude. We have to make sure they're the right quality of piña for us to produce the right quality of product that we already have. That's where the juices come from, that particular piña, for us to produce tequila. And this one here is like the perfect one, man. This one looks great.
Yeah, looks perfect. Yeah,
I'm happy. What happened with the pencas is that they left here on the side. Several months from today, they actually put that back in there to fertilize the area. And that'll relieve the soil with other minerals that are gonna help the next piñas grow. So nothing goes to waste. I can't wait to see and taste our new product.
Coming up, hard work pays off with a great tasting tequila.
In order for us to get to that perfect alcohol content and taste, it takes a lot of meticulous moves within our engineering.
And then, Casa Mexico catches the eye of Mario Lopez.
It was celebrated and consumed a lot at my wedding.
That's all next on The Art of Tequila. Welcome back to The Art of Tequila. In the highlands of Jalisco, Mexico, the epicenter of all tequila production in the world, Eric Buccio of Casa Mexico Tequila and his team of Jimadores harvest the agave piñas that will be turned into their premium tequila. Once collected, the piñas are brought into the distillery where they're placed into a massive brick oven to be roasted.
It's probably one of the most interesting parts of the piña, because that's what the piña is matured for. The roasting part expels all the sugars that eventually become the alcohol. When we put our pines in the oven, that oven could sit 72 hours, and you have to wait for those sugars to actually be expelled from that piña.
Right now in the oven, we have around 500 piñas, which is 11,000 kilos. And we can get from that, we can get around 1,500 liters of tequila.
The roasted piñas are then smashed into a pulp called mosto, which is added into the fermentation tank along with the extracted sugars and yeast, which consumes the sugar, creating alcohol. It then goes into the distillation process.
The distillation process takes out from the tequila all the impurities, and we do it twice. Yeah, it's an extra step that we do. By distilling it twice, we can get a more pure tequila.
And in order for us to get to that right, perfect alcohol content and taste, it takes a lot of meticulous moves within our engineering. We have to make sure that it has no impurities and it tastes exactly like our last batch taste.
After distillation, the resulting tequila, considered a silver tequila, is bottled and sold. The entire process, from harvesting the agave plant to bottling, only takes 4 days.
I like the figure, bro. This is cool.
Yeah, I like it.
Nice. Very good. Now let's go to the quality control of this area. And let's proceed. It's very important really to quality control every single step that has to do with the tequila process. Making sure our bottles are right, making sure our labels are perfect, our tops are perfect, and the final outcome, which is a perfect bottle with a nice top and the perfect product within the bottle.
Everything's looking great, man. This is amazing. Very clear, nice and shiny, crystal clear.
Yep, great job, man.
I love it, dude. I love it. It's very good. I like it. I love it. I love it.
Because the piña grows for so long and is affected by the elements, the taste can vary from year to year. Every batch must be sampled and approved to make sure it is up to the standards of Casa Mexico.
So guys, here we are today, 8 years in the making, man. This is a, I gotta say that this is a huge moment for us. Very interesting to find and sort of fine tune what we've created.
The range of tequilas that we have is silver, reposado, and añejo. The difference between all three is the silver is not aged. After filtration, after distillation, it goes directly into the bottle. The best way of drinking a true tasting tequila is with the silver or blanco. That's really the virgin way of drinking a true tequila without being aged.
So we're gonna start with the silver.
It's great.
It's perfect. I think it's right there with our last batch. Actually a little sweeter, which I really like because it feels nice and smooth.
The reposado is a 1-year American oak barrel aged. So it takes a whole year for it to actually mature.
Very smooth.
Actually, this one's smoother than our last batch.
Than the last one, yeah.
Remember, El Reposado was the one we had the hardest time sort of fine-tuned right in the middle? I think we got it with this one.
But now we got it. It's got more vanilla taste to it.
Last but not least, the Añejo.
Our Añejo is a 2-year American oak barrel. So it actually takes 8 years to get a silver, takes 9 years to get a Reposado, and it takes 10 years to make an Añejo. And what you're gonna find and taste, it's basically just the smokiness of the barrel. And a lot of people, depending on the palate, they'll feel a little vanilla, a little cinnamon, a little sweet. And some people love just that oakiness.
It's a lot smoother.
A lot smoother than the last one.
Still the smoky taste still there, but very smooth. I love it.
I think with this batch, if we continue doing the same thing that we're doing now, it could only get better. Yeah, that's actually gonna be a great seller.
What I typically look for in tequila is smooth and subtle. You don't need to shoot the tequila. No chaser needed. If you have to take a chaser, there's an issue in what you're drinking. But if you sip it on the rocks, like a cognac, like a whiskey, that's the way I've always looked at it.
Wow, está buenísimo, güey.
Very smooth. I didn't even think it could get any smoother.
The experience I want with Casa Mexico with people is that to know, for them to know that when they taste Casa Mexico products, they know they're getting something authentic. Something that takes a long time to do, something that we're very passionate about. You know, it's been a long journey. From the moment I purchased my first agaves to this day, it's been about 15 years. It's been an amazing ride. Guys, United States, here we come once again. Salud. Salud.
Casa Mexico.
Coming up, the Casa Mexico partners create and sample signature tequila cocktails.
It's got a good flavor to it. I want to eat it.
Exactly.
You know, it's got a good flavor to it.
It's delicious.
That's all next on The Art of Tequila. Welcome back to The Art of Tequila.
My name is Mario Lopez. I'm a partner with Casa Mexico Tequila. I think the art of tequila, and especially in my culture, is that it's used, whether it's something celebratory, like a wedding or something tragic, someone's passing. You're with friends, you're with family, you're with people you care about. You either are drinking your joys or drinking your sorrows, and it's important, but it's all about uniting, creating those moments. I've had a long history and love affair with tequila. I mean, being Mexican, it's obviously part of our culture, but as I've gotten older, I've gotten educated on tequila. When you get good tequila, it often goes down like a nice wine, and I really grew to appreciate it and come to learn, like much like wine, there's hundreds of different types and flavors in the history, and it's really cool just culturally, and I got to appreciate learning about it.
Eric Buccio started producing Casa Mexico tequila in 2001 and is now ready to launch wide in the United States. Today, Eric, Mario, and their fellow business partner, Mark Roberts, meet at Mario's home to approve Casa Mexico's signature cocktails.
Sorry, I'm so excited to taste our drinks. And obviously, I think we're gonna start with the paloma.
Absolutely. So we're gonna do 2 ounces here of the Casa Mexico Silver.
Perfecto.
We're gonna do 1/2 ounce of lime juice. Just a little pinch of salt here.
Perfect. I think that's what gives it the final touch.
Absolutely.
To our product.
And then we're gonna shake that really well. I'm just gonna strain this here into a Collins glass. And then we're gonna top this off with a little bit of grapefruit soda.
Perfecto.
It's gonna be really refreshing, a little bit of carbonation in there. And then give you a fresh grapefruit wedge as a garnish.
Perfecto.
And that, buddy, is all yours.
Let's taste.
Hey, guys. Hey, what's
up? We got some drinks here.
Ooh, that looks refreshing, refreshing.
As you guys know.
You're welcome.
National rollout. I need your guys' point of view with the drinks. Erika? She's mixed some amazing drinks here.
What do we call this?
This is the Casa Mexico Paloma.
This is for the rollout to the restaurants, right?
Restaurant National.
So there'll be a menu that says Casa Mexico mixed drinks available, and it goes out in chains.
Exactly.
Oh, it looks refreshing.
Cool. Paloma, Salud. Casa Mexico.
Salud. 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 Salud.
It's very spa-like, refreshing, but you can feel the tequila, but not too much.
Spa-like is exactly
That's exactly right.
You know,
exactly
right.
What do you think?
Right, perfect, dude. This is just what we're looking for.
So we got approval on this. We have 2 more drinks. Remember, we need 3.
Okay.
So this is just 1 down. Let's go get 2 more.
Thanks, guys.
Get the other ones.
This is great. Let me just have 1 more.
Alrighty, so now we're gonna kick off with the Blue Diamond in there. What we're gonna do now is we're gonna start off with 1.5 ounces of the silver tequila. We're just gonna do 1/2 ounce of the blue curacao to give it that gorgeous blue color that you're used to seeing. We're gonna do 1/4 ounce of lime juice. And then we're also
nice.
Gonna shake this and have it nice. Strain this over here, and look at this color that comes out here. It's just
I love
gorgeous.
It.
You see where we got the name, yeah?
Most definitely the blue diamond. I love the color.
Garnish it with a fresh lime wedge. And you're all set.
Guys. Oh, wow, look at
there
that.
Go.
I know you know this.
Dude, this is aqua style. Look at this is.
The blue diamond, right?
Hey, I remember it all
Yeah,
too
this
well.
Was Salud. A big hit.
It was invented for Mario's wedding?
Really?
It was a big hit. Casa Mexico Tequila is always going to be special because it was celebrated and consumed a lot at my wedding. And people really loved it, but when they were really enjoying it, and whether it was in a margarita or just on the rocks, then I was like, huh, you know, this is good stuff.
These are dangerous.
These dangerously smooth.
These creep up on you.
Wow, that is good, right?
Great
Cheers,
job.
Man, great
Cheers,
drink.
Salud.
So this is official, right? We're going with
official.
The blue diamond.
Yeah, we're
going
to go with the blue diamond.
Nice. 2 down.
1 to go.
We're ready. Back. Ready. All right.
Thank you.
Sorry, I drank it all.
Casa Mexico tequila can be consumed so many different ways, whether it's a traditional margarita or much on the rocks or even just neat, as if you were to sipping. My name is Mario Lopez. I'm a partner with Casa Mexico Tequila. I think the art of tequila, and especially in my culture, is that it's used, whether it's something celebratory like a wedding or something tragic, someone's passing, you're with friends, you're with family, you're with people you care about. You either are drinking your joys or drinking your sorrows, and it's important, but it's all about uniting, creating those moments. I've had a long history and love affair with tequila. I mean, being Mexican, it's obviously part of our culture, but as I've gotten older, I've gotten educated on tequila. When you get good tequila, it often goes down like a nice wine, and I really grew to appreciate it and come to learn, like much like wine, there's hundreds of different types and flavors in the history, and it's really cool just culturally, and I got to appreciate learning about it.
Eric Buccio started producing Casa Mexico Tequila in 2001 and is now ready to launch wide in the United States. Today, Eric, Mario, and their fellow business partner Mark Roberts meet at Mario's home to approve Casa Mexico's signature cocktails.
Sorry, I'm so excited to taste our drinks. And obviously, I think we're gonna start with the Paloma.
Absolutely. So we're gonna do 2 ounces here of the Casa Mexico Silver.
Perfecto.
We're gonna do 1/2 ounce of lime juice. Just a little pinch of salt here.
Perfect. I think that's what gives it the final touch.
Absolutely.
To our product.
And then we're gonna shake that really well. I'm just gonna strain this here into a Collins glass. And then we're gonna top this off with a little bit of grapefruit soda.
Perfecto.
It's gonna be really refreshing. A little bit of carbonation in there. And then give you a fresh grapefruit wedge as a garnish.
Perfecto.
And that, buddy, is all yours.
Let's taste.
Hey, guys. Hey,
we got some drinks here.
Ooh, ooh, that looks refreshing, refreshing.
As you guys know.
You're welcome.
National rollout. I need your guys' point of view with the drinks. Erika, she's mixed some amazing drinks here.
What do we call this?
This is the Casa Mexico Paloma.
This is for the rollout to the restaurants, right?
Restaurant national.
So there'll be a menu that says Casa Mexico mixed drinks available, and it goes out in chains.
Exactly.
Yeah, it looks refreshing.
Cool. Yes. Paloma, salud. Casa Mexico.
Salud. 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 Salud.
It's very spa-like, refreshing, but you can feel the tequila, but not too much.
Spa-like is exactly.
That's exactly right.
You know?
That's exactly
right.
What do you think?
Right. Perfect, dude. This is just what we're looking for.
So we got approval on this. We have two more drinks. Remember, we need three.
Okay.
So this is just one down. Let's go get two more.
Thanks, guys.
The other ones.
This is great. Let me just have one more.
Alrighty, so now we're gonna kick off with the Blue Diamond. And there, what we're gonna do now is we're gonna start off with an ounce and a half of the silver tequila. We're just gonna do a half an ounce of the Blue Curacao to give it that
perfect,
gorgeous blue color that you're used to seeing. We're gonna do a quarter of an ounce of lime juice. And then we're also
nice.
Shake this and make it nice. Strain this over here, and look at this color that comes out here. It's just
I love it.
Gorgeous. You see where we got the name, yeah?
Most definitely the Blue Diamond. I love the color.
Garnish it with a fresh lime wedge. And you're all set.
Guys. Oh wow, look at
there
that.
We go.
I know you know this.
Dude, this is aqua style. Look at this is.
The Blue Diamond, right?
Hey, I remember it all.
Yeah, this was a big hit.
It was invented for Mario's wedding.
It was a big hit. Casa Mexico Tequila is always going to be special because it was celebrated and consumed a lot at my wedding. And people really loved it. But when they were really enjoying it, and whether it was in a margarita or just on the rocks, then I was like, huh. You know, this is good stuff.
These are dangerous.
These dangerously smooth.
These creep up on you.
Wow, that is good, right?
Well, great
cheers,
job.
Man. Great drink.
Salud.
So this is official, nice right? We're going
this is
with
official.
The Blue Diamond.
Yeah, we're gonna go with the Blue Diamond.
Nice. Two down.
One to go. We're
ready.
Right back.
Ready. All right.
Thank you.
Sorry, I drank it all.
Casa Mexico tequila can be consumed so many different ways, whether it's a traditional margarita or much on the rocks or even just neat, as if you were sipping it as a wine, and whether it's the silver or the reposado or the añejo, they're all very distinct flavors, and it's cool to see which one people gravitate to.
So third and final?
We're gonna be doing the Casa Mexico Margarita. So we're gonna start off with 2 ounces of the Casa Mexico Silver here. I'm gonna do an ounce of triple sec. Just under a half an ounce of the lime juice. And then we're just gonna do a splash of sweet and sour, and we're gonna shake this over ice.
Wow, it looks so good.
And then tell me if that isn't incredibly refreshing.
Oh man, ooh, I want whatever
we're
this
going,
is.
We're going
last but not least.
OG.
You guys
definitely
know one thing. You guys know one thing. Worldwide, margarita is the number one tequila mixed drink in the world. So this is a must have a brew. All right, guys.
Right.
This is it. Yes. Let's try this.
These are my favorite. These are my favorite. It's got a good flavor to it,
that's
huh?
Really
I want to eat it.
Exactly.
You know, it's got a good flavor to it.
It's delicious.
Margaritas, to me, are like the quintessential tequila drink, right? It's delicious. And at the same time, it represents party, celebration, fiesta. I hope the Casa Mexico Tequila customers experience a high quality, product that they love to consume, that they think about when they want to celebrate, that creates great memories for friends and family when they get together. That's their go-to drink whenever it's time to celebrate for whatever the occasion is.
Well, look, these are fantastic. These were great. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I think Casa Mexico really is featured in these.
Yeah.
I think we did a great job.
Yeah. Salud.
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 Cheers to much more.